So Apple's taken a beating the last couple of weeks. It's shed the equivalent of Boeing. It's lost about $100 billion in market cap from its high. Why is that? Speculation over the Apple Watch. The Apple Watch is a huge hit. What did they need to do with the Apple Watch? One, they needed license to do 2.0, and they have that. And it has solidified their position as the best luxury brand in the world. Who's wearing the Apple Watch? Anybody that matters in fashion. I met with the entire senior management team of Sephora. All of them were wearing Apple Watches. This is a group right out of central casting and possibly smart and good looking at the same time. Apple is absolutely killing it. $1 trillion, here we come. A winner, Palantir. If you look at the list of the most valuable startups, it begins predictably with Uber, followed by Xiaomi, and then Airbnb. Number four on the list, Palantir. Palantir builds software that ties databases together to make it easier to search and analyze information. I think that's called big data, isn't it? Anyways, its clients include police agencies, intelligence services, and financial institutions. The firm booked more than $1 billion in 2014, cementing its position among unicorns. The other big winner here, the U.S. According to the Wall Street Journal, 72 of the 108 unicorns are in the U.S. versus 26 in Asia, 1 in Israel, and only 9 in Europe. Europe is literally falling off the planet. Innovation is dead and dying and gone in Europe. So a winner, tennis, with the U.S. Open set to start next week. The sport's social media season is in full swing. Only basketball and football players have more followers. If we take a closer look, Rafael Nadal has the most followers with an impressive 23 million across Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. The most popular player on Facebook, Maria Sharapova, who boasts more than 14.5 million followers. Serena Williams is number one on Instagram with over 1 million followers, considerably more than her peer group. But the most important metric for brands, who does the best job integrating their sponsored messages? The winner here, Andy Murray, who makes Standard Life and Under Armour big winners and integrates them well into his social media missives. A winner, Imgur. I had never heard of Imgur, but it's the most popular file sharing platform in the world and is formally open to advertising. More than 60 billion images are viewed per month on Imgur, largely because it's the default platform for hosting Reddit images, and Imgur has over 150 million active users. That is double the traffic of Pinterest. Imgur has a 75% male audience, offering advertisers a chance to attract the notoriously hard-to-reach demographic of millennial men. We decided to check out Imgur, and this is literally the first image or the first video that came up. We love this. It's both really disturbing and hilarious at the same time, kind of like my sex life, but anyways, enjoy. We'll see you in 2 weeks.